boys and girls, and welcome to 5-Minute Bedtime Stories with Miss Elaine. Tonight we're going to read a book about a bat. It's called Stella Luna. This was actually requested by my friend Bella. So Bella, this one is for you. In a warm and sultry forest, far, far away, there once lived a mother fruit bat and her new baby. Oh, how mother bat loved her soft, tiny baby. "I'll name you Stella Luna," she cried. Each night, Mother Bat would carry Stella Luna clutched to her breast as she flew out in search for food. One night, as Mother Bat followed the heavy scent of ripe fruit, an owl spied her. On silent wings, the powerful bird swooped down upon the bats. Dodging and shrieking, Mother Bat tried to escape, but the owl struck again and again, knocking Stella Luna into the air. Her baby wings were as limp and as useless as wet paper. Down, down, down she went, faster and faster, into the forest below. Oh no, so when the owl attacked, the mommy bat and the baby bat, Stella Luna, got separated. The dark leafy tangle of branches caught Stella Luna as she fell. One twig was small enough for Stella Luna's tiny feet. Wrapping her wings about her, she clutched the thin branch, trembling with cold and fear. "Mother," Stella Luna squeaked. "Mother, where are you?" By daybreak, the baby bat could hold on no longer. So again, down, 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 she dropped. Flump! Stella Luna landed headfirst in a soft, downy nest, startling the three baby birds who lived there. Stella Luna quickly clambered from the nest and hung out of sight below it. She listened to the babble of the three birds. "What was that?" cried Flap. "I don't know, but it's hanging by its feet," chirped Flitter.
"Shh! Here comes Mama," hissed Pip.
Many, many times that day, Mama Bird flew away, always returning with food for her babies. Stella Luna was terribly hungry, but not for the crawly things Mama Bird brought. Finally, though, the little bat could bear it no longer. She climbed into the nest, closed her eyes, and opened her mouth. Plop! In dropped a big green grasshopper. Stella Luna learned to be like the birds. She stayed awake all day and slept at night. She ate bugs, even though they tasted awful. Her bat ways were quickly disappearing. Except for one thing, Stella Luna still liked to sleep hanging by her feet. Once, when Mama was away, the curious baby birds decided to try it too. When Mama Bird came home, she saw 8 tiny feet gripping the edge of the nest. "Eek!" she cried. "Get back up here this instant! You're going to fall and break your necks!" So the birds clambered back into the nest, but Mama Bird stopped Stella Luna. "You are teaching my children to do bad things. I will not let you back into this nest unless you promise to obey all the rules of this house." Stella Luna promised. She ate bugs without making faces. She slept in the nest at night, and she didn't hang by her feet anymore. Stella Luna behaved as a good bird should. All the babies grew quickly, and soon the nest became crowded. Mama Bird told them it was time to learn to fly. One by one, Pip, Flitter, Flap, and Stella Luna jumped from the nest. Their wings worked. "Huh, I'm just like them," thought Stella Luna. "I can fly too." Pip, Flitter, and Flap landed gracefully on a branch. Stella Luna tried to do the same. "How embarrassing. I will fly all day," Stella Luna told herself. "Then no one will see how clumsy I am." All alone, Stella Luna flew and flew until her wings ached and she dropped into a tree. "I promised not to hang by my feet," Stella Luna sighed. So she hung by her thumbs and soon fell asleep. She didn't hear the soft sound of wings coming near. "Hey," a loud voice said, "why are you hanging upside down?" Stella Luna's eyes opened wide, and she saw a most peculiar face. "I'm not upside down. You are," Stella Luna said. "Ah, but you're a bat. Bats hang by their feet.
You are hanging by your thumb. So that makes you upside down, the creature said. I'm a bat. I'm hanging by my feet. And that makes me right side up. Stella Luna was confused. Mama Bird told me I was upside down. She said I was wrong. Wrong for a bird, maybe, but not for a bat. More bats gathered around to see the strange young bat who behaved like a bird. Stella Luna told them her story. You ate bugs? Stuttered one. You slept at night? Gasped another. How very strange, they all murmured. Wait, wait, let me look at this child. A bat pushed through the crowd. An owl attacked you? She asked. Sniffing Stella Luna's fur, she whispered, You are Stella Luna. You are my baby. Were they reunited? Stella Luna found her mama, or her mama found her. They're back together. You escaped the owl? Cried Stella Luna. You survived? Yes, said Mother Bat as she wrapped her wings around Stella Luna. Come with me, and I'll show you where to find the most delicious fruit. You'll never have to eat another bug as long as you live.
But it's nighttime, Stella Luna squeaked. We can't fly in the dark or we'll crash into trees.
We're bats, said Mother Bat. We can see in the darkness. Come with me. Stella Luna was afraid, but she let go of the tree and dropped into the deep blue sky. Stella Luna could see. She felt as though rays of light shone from her eyes. She was able to see everything in her path. Soon the bats found a mango tree, and Stella Luna ate as much of that fruit as she could hold. I'll never eat another bug as long as I live, cheered Stella Luna. I must tell Pip, Flitter, and Flap. The next day, Stella Luna went to visit the birds. Come with me and meet my bat family, said Stella Luna.
Okay, let's go, agreed Pip.
They hang by their feet and they fly at night and they eat the best food in the world, Stella Luna explained.
As the birds flew among the bats, Flap said, I feel upside down here.
So the birds hung by their feet.
Wait until dark, Stella Luna said excitedly. We will fly at night.
When night came, Stella Luna flew away. Pip, Flitter, and Flap left from the tree to follow her.
I can't see a thing, yelled Pip.
Neither can I, howled Flitter.
Ah! Shrieked Flap.
They're going to crash, gasped Stella Luna. I must rescue them. Stella Luna swooped about, grabbing her friends in the air. She lifted them to a tree, and the birds grasped a branch. Stella Luna hung from the limb above them.
We're safe, said Stella Luna, and then she sighed.
I wish you could see in the dark, too.
We wish you could land on your feet, Flitter replied.
Pip and Flap nodded. They perched in silence for a long time.
How can we be so different and feel so much alike? Mused Flitter.
And how can we feel so different and be so much alike? Wondered Pip.
I think it is quite a mystery, Flap chirped.
I agree, said Stella Luna. But we're friends, and that's a fact.
The end. And that's so true, boys and girls. I just love that message. You can be friends with other people, even if they don't look exactly like you or act exactly like you. That's what makes us all special. And we can all be friends, no matter what. What a wonderful message from Stella Luna.
Well, it's time for our two special lullabies. We're going to sing Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star, followed by God Bless the Moon. Will you sing with me at home? Here we go.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are.
Very good. And now the moon song. I see the moon and the moon sees me. God bless the moon and God bless me.
God bless you boys and girls at home. Thank you so much for watching. And I'll see you again real soon on 5-Minute Bedtime Stories with Miss Elaine. Good night.